Hey guys, I thought I'd review my Tanita body fat scales. Exciting, I know. I've looked through a lot of makes and models before deciding on these, and hopefully this video helps other people come to a decision. I own the Tanita BC-543 body composition monitor scales, which is just a fancy way of saying it will tell you more than just your weight. I got these from John Lewis 4 months ago for £70. Importantly, it has a 3-year guarantee because I found the majority of negative reviews related to either damage to the glass platform or the console simply not working after 6 to 12 months. So I'll show you a quick test run. You can set up your profile or just use guest mode. It needs to know your age, whether you are male or female and an athlete or non-athlete, and your height. To qualify as an athlete, according to them, you need around 10 hours a week of intense exercise and a resting heart rate of 60 beats a minute or lower. It's not suitable for pro athletes or bodybuilders. And importantly, it struggles with changes in the amount of water in your body, which you'll see later. There's a switch on the back to choose either pounds, kilos, or stone and pounds. I'm set to kilos, so let's go. I'm user 1, so I will press 1. Then it shows me the age and height associated with that profile. And finally, when it shows 0.0, it means I can step on. You need to be in bare feet because the scales send a small electrical current through your body via these toe and heel pads. And for that reason, your feet should also be dry. That current acts differently when passing through muscle or fat, and that's how it works out the numbers. So it immediately gives you your weight and your body fat percentage, but there's plenty of other information. If you press the guy lifting weights, it will tell you your lean mass, which is slightly different to what the fat percentage would suggest. That's because it also takes into account bone mineral mass, which you can get from pressing the skeleton image. And for me, that's 3.0 kilos. Overall weight minus muscle mass minus bone mass leaves me with X. X divided by overall weight gets me back to my body fat percentage. You might have also noticed the number 5 came up after lean mass. That's my physique rating. It's 1 to 9, but a higher number isn't necessarily better. This is something like BMI, but taking into account muscle. Here's what their chart looks like. Then you have BMR, Basal Metabolic Rate, which is how many calories you'd burn just from being alive. In sports science, they used to say it's what you'd burn in 24 hours if all you did was lie on the floor. There's an equation behind the scenes that works this out. If you look at the Harris-Benedict equation, where W is my weight in kilos, H is height in centimeters, and A is age in years, you get pretty close to what the scale is telling me. You can look at visceral fat rating, which is this symbol here. That's the amount of fat around your internal organs, more dangerous than subcutaneous fat. My number is 5. I'm not sure whether that's 5% of my fat around my organs or just a rating, but below 9 is fine and above 9 is a concern. Then you can press the water droplet to see your body water content. This should fall in a different range for males and females. As you'll see, it ends up being highly correlated with your body fat percentage. One last feature is the set button. If you're on a profile and have used the scales before, it will tell you the readings from the last time you used it when you press the set button. So you can see current and previous readings for every measure on the scale. Okay, so now you've seen what it offers, but the two main things that you really want from a scale are reliability and accuracy. Reliability is how well it reports your exact weight and other stats, and accuracy is how close it's getting to the true values. Last night I weighed myself 5 times on 5 different parts of my bathroom floor, and here's what I found. You can see my weight only differed by 100 grams, lean mass by 200 grams, and water and body fat by 0.3%. Other values like bone mass were the same each time, so pretty damn good. You also want accuracy. There's no point if the scale tells me I'm 18% fat every time when I'm really 30%. For this I like to use visual measures. You can go to Google and you can look up body fat percentages and you'll get a set of pictures. And you can compare these to see which range you fall into. For me, I'd say I'm not as lean as this guy, but I'm not as doughy as this one, which puts me in 15 to 19% territory. And that's exactly what I found. I weigh myself every few days. My lowest has been exactly 15%, and my highest was 18.5%. After the first month of using the scale, I did notice a pattern between what it said my hydration status was and what it said my lean mass was. In fact, looking at my last 20 readings and using Excel's correlation function on my body water percentage and body fat percentage columns, you get minus 0.988, meaning almost the perfect inverse relationship. This looks a lot clearer when I plot a graph. I haven't been trying to gain muscle or lose fat, so these should be quite similar. If you read the manual, it does state that to obtain the most accurate measures, you shouldn't use the scales within several hours of waking up, eating, or intense exercise, mainly because those things affect your hydration status. Overall, I think these are very good scales. My motivation for purchasing them was I had a health check at work and I got on a sophisticated set of scales. It had the hand grips and that told me I was 18% fat. Knowing now that that was done first thing in the morning and would have given me a higher reading means that I'm getting very similar measurements off my cheaper scales than I have from more expensive ones. The huge downside is they seem to consistently break for a lot of users. I'd imagine a lot of the positive reviews are from people like me who've only had them a few months and not had any problems. If you do choose to buy them, I would look for warranties or multi-year guarantees, as it seems almost inevitable that they're going to break, which is a shame because otherwise they're a very good product. Thanks for watching.